Wishing Condition und Pilot. So, we may look on what will be the effect of the file when we apply or use or install any machines that have a vibrations, okay, on the top of the foundation systems. Okay. So, brief explanation on the machine foundations. Okay. So, machine foundation design, which is also known as machinery foundation design, is accomplished to protect the adjacent foundation of the structure from the vibration of rotating or vibrating machine. Okay. So, is that we have a certain machine that can provide vibrations, okay, during the operating. Okay. So, in order to make sure that it doesn't cause any problem to the other structure, okay, so the machine should a special foundation should be designed. Okay. So there will be several type of foundations, okay, which is block type, box type, wall types, frame types. Okay. So on the top of that, for example, if the if the structure, if the ground is not sufficient to sustain the foundations under a shallow, so a pile system should be used. Okay. It is also possible that the soil condition are such that the vibration of shallow machine condition may lead to undesirable settlement. Okay. So in many circumstances, the load bearing capacity of the soil may be low compared to the static and dynamic load imposed by the machine and the shallow foundation. Okay. So for example, if the system could be handled or could be sustained well by shallow foundation, so we can just use the shallow foundation. Okay. However, in the case that the design we then did take consideration of the use of the pile, so we need to use the deep foundation methods or systems. Okay. If you keep in mind that the use of the pile will in general increase the natural frequency of the saw pile system and may also increase the amplitude of vibration at resonance. Okay. So for each system or for each structure, they have their own natural frequency. Okay. So we need to make sure that this natural frequency is not be acid during the operating of the any machines. Okay. So if it acid the natural frequency, so definitely the system will be collapsed. Okay. So for the machine foundation on the pile, we only discuss on the natural how to obtain to calculate for the natural frequency. Either on what we call it on the end bearing or another methods is a friction pile. Okay. In general, pipe can divide into two broad categories: end bearing pile. Okay. This pipe penetrates through soft soil layer up to a hard stratum or rock. The hard stratum or rock can be considered as rigid. Okay. Another pile is friction pile or floating pile, okay, where the tips of the pile does not rest on hard stratum. The pile resists the applied load by means of friction resistance developed at the saw pile interface. Okay. There will be two type of pile, okay, used in the constructions. Okay. So the length of the pile is equal to L, and the load of the pile coming from the foundation is W. This problem can be approximately treated as a vertical rod fixed at the base, okay, and free on the top. Okay. So that is the analogy that can be used. For determining the natural frequency of the pile, three possible cases may arise. Okay. So for this type of condition, okay, so we have three for this type of end bearing part. So there will be three possible cases, okay, that could be considered. So for example, if W is very small, the natural frequency of vibration can be given by the following equation. So this is how we determine the natural frequency, okay, for the pile, the system. So in this case, I guess it will be provided, okay, to calculate for this natural frequency. Okay. So then how could we measure either it acid or not? So normally we may use an accelerometer system. Okay. So we may measure during the operations of the machine, for example, okay, to be attached on the on the foundation systems. So that is for the first one. Okay. While for the second case, if W is the same order of the magnitude as width of the pi, the natural frequency observation can be given by equation, okay, by the equation, by this equation, okay, where at the end we need to determine what will be the ln, value, sorry, omega. So from the omega, we put inside this equations. Okay, so this is how to get the value between the ln, between the omega, to get the value of the omega. And the last one, if W is larger and the width of the pipe is negligible in comparison, then equation of this should be used. Okay. So to up to okay the value for the unit weight of the pile, okay, and also EP could be referred to this what we call as table. For the case number two doesn't require for the EP and the gamma P. Or we can directly use this what we call as this figure, okay, to obtain what will be the natural frequency directly from this figure for certain type of material with certain type of length. Okay, so this is an example to calculate for the for the case of end bearing. Okay, so the information given here is the pile length is 24, and the cross sections, okay, or the diameter or the cross section is 0.3 times 0.3. The weight of the machine and the foundation is 1360. The unit weight is 24, and the modulus of elasticity is 24.5 times 10 power by 6. So EP is equal to 24.5 and 6, where unit pile is 24. Determine the natural frequency of the pile foundations. Okay. So in this case, they have four pre-stressed, okay, four pre-stressed concrete pile driven to the bedrock. So bedrock, so in this case we refer to the end bearing. Okay. The weight carried by each pipe is 340. So the weight of each pile is, then we make calculate what will be the weight of each pile. Because we want to get the idea which cases that we should be used. Okay. So the weight of the pile is 0.3 times 0.3 times the length, and also time the unit width of the concrete. So we obtain 51.84. So that is the value for the value of the width. So I guess for this case, we may use the equations from the case number. We may look on the case which one should be used. Okay. So the case number 3, because the W is larger and the width of the pile is negligible. Okay. So for example, if the W is same order of magnitude of the width of the pile, so we may use the case number 2. For this case, the what we call as the W is larger than the width of the pile, okay? Because this is the width, 340, and this is the width of the pile, 51.84. Okay. Okay, then then we start to calculate for the VCP, okay? So based on the formula, the VCP. So this is the formula for the VCP, okay, to get the VCP value. So it's because it's not been provided previously. Okay. So square root of EP over rho P. Okay. So EP is equal to the what we call as the modulus of elasticity, 24.5 times 10 power by 6 kPa, okay, over rho P, okay. 24 is the what we call it is the unit width of the pile, yeah, of the concrete, okay. 24.24 kilometer per meter cube. And then divide with 9.81. I guess the equation is not provided with. Okay, if divide with 9.81 means that the rho P should be divided with the G. Okay. I will confirm back with this equations later on. Okay. So 3164.6. Okay. So from there, they calculate. They use the equation of the equation of 11.2. Okay. Which is also not been provided previously. Okay. So AL gamma LL gamma P is equal to 51.84, okay, over 340 for the W, okay, equal to long equal to omega 24 is the length of the pile, okay. VCP is equal to 3654.6, okay. Then tangent with the omega 24 over 3164.46. Okay. Then from there, they have this kind of value, okay, which is 0.1525 equal to omega 0.00758, tangent omega 0.00758. So from the figure 11.2, okay, for L, okay, so then we may use the this figure, okay, to get the value of the L, the value of the to get the value of the L gamma P over sigma. Okay, or we can use this value, okay, to determine the value of this one. So ln L over VCP is equal to 0.36, okay, based on the this diagram. Sorry, zero. Okay, zero. 0.0 point 1525. We use okay, 0.1. 1, 2, 3 here. Okay, and then draw a line until it go to the horizontal to get the omega n over VCP. So from there we can estimate the value for the ln, for the omega. So the omega will be 47.5. Okay, so from the omega we can use 47.36 is the formula for the So we get 47 for the 47.5, okay. So 47.5 for the omega. Then by using the formula for this one, this is the basic formula for to get the Fn. So Fn is equal to 47.5 over 2, 2, 2, 5. So the result is 72.56. Let me calculate first. Okay, so we obtain 7.56. So 47.5 over 2, 2, 2, 2 pi, 7.56 hertz. So we confirm again with this formula. Where they get the value for the fees, rho p over gravity. Okay, now for the friction pile. Yeah, this figure show a pile having a length of embankment equal to L and radius of R. The pile is subject to a dynamic loads. Okay. So for the friction, it is a floating where we assume that the bedrock is far from the foundations, far from the pile. So it's possible to analyze the pile to a mass spring dashpot system as shown in figure B. So the mass M shown in the figure can be assumed to be the mass of the cap and machinery. The mathematical formulation for obtaining the stiffness, which is a Kz, and the damping Cz parameter have been given by Novak. So in developing the theory, the following assumption will be the pile is vertical, elastic, and circular in cross section. The pile is floating. The pile is perfectly connected to the soil. The soil above the pile tips behave as infinitesimal thin. Okay. Independently linear elastic layer assumption of plane strain condition. So this is the assumption being made by Novak. Okay. So this is how to get the capacity. For the pile where Kz is the stiffness, C is the damping. Okay. So this is the equation to get the Kz, this is the equation to get the Cz. Okay. So we need to get, you may use the value for the G, okay, the shear modulus of soil. Okay, so this is how we determine the Fz1 and Fz based on the ratio of L over R for the floating type. Okay. So that is for the floating one. Okay. And then the example will be shown by using the group of pi systems. Okay. So pi foundation are generally constructed in the groups. The stiffness and damping constants of a pi are not simple summation of the stiffness and damping constant of individual piles. So Novak suggested that when the pi are closed space, the displacement of one pile is increased due to the displacement of other pile, and conversely, the stiffness and damping of the group are reduced. Hence, the stiffness of the pi can be obtained. Okay, so this is the formula for a pi groups, where they introduce the interaction factor, which is the alpha R. So the alpha R is obtained from the static interaction factor from this chart. Okay. So it depends on the number of the pile. For example, if you have 2 pile, 3 pile, 4 piles, and it depends on the spacing. This is spacing, but this is the diameter. Okay, so this is one example of the how to get the interaction factor. Okay. So for a group pile, a cap is constructed over the pile. Okay. In the estimation of the stiffness and damping constant, contribution of the pile cap should be ignored. Okay. The relationship describing the stiffness and geometric damping of embedded condition are given as below. Okay. So this is the formula to be used, okay, to get the capacity of the of pile, okay, which is this is the stiffness, while this is the damping. So the damping ratio should be calculated for the undamped natural frequency. This is the without any damping system. Damped natural frequency. Okay. is the natural frequency, with the dynamic frequency. Amplitude of variation of resonance. So this is formula would be used and should be used later on. So this will be another equation. Honestly, it's very difficult to understand all this. But we just follow the procedure how to calculate value. Okay. So this is example, okay, on how to determine what we call as the KZ and CZ, for a group of pi. For example, for this figure. So we be provided with the EP, which is the modulus of the pile, Young modulus, and the shear modulus, GS, and the unit weight of soil, 19, and assume Poisson ratio of 0.2. So then to begin with, we need to calculate for the cross section of the pile, by using the to get the radius, because the size of the pile is 0.3 over 0.3. So we try to get the radius, equivalent radius, to make sure that the pile behave like this. So the length of the pile is equal to 12, L over R is equal to 70.6. Then we'll be provided with the EP, 21 times 10 power by 6, and also the GS, 28,000. So the ratio between EP over G is to 750. Okay. So then we refer to the previous diagram, this one, to get what will be the FZ 1 and FZ 2, based on the ratio of EP over G and L over R. So the value of the FZ 1 is equal to 0.034 and FZ2 is 0.06. Okay. So then the equation for the KZ is on the previous, is on this one. Okay. So we can calculate the value for the KZ, and also for the CZ. So the KZ is equal to 378, 378 times 10 power by 6, and for the EZ, so we need to calculate for the CZ. Sorry, CZ, we need to calculate the CZ. So the CZ is equal to 94.311. Okay, so that is for the CZ. But yet, we're not finished yet. So in order to determine, that is for the KZ. So in here we have also the alpha R. So the alpha R, based on the figure, based on this figure, so we need to determine what will be the alpha R. For our case, we have four type of pile, with a certain S over D value. So the author has put in the table, so to find what will be the alpha R. So based on their finding, the alpha R is around 2.6, 2.56. So this is how to sorry, so this is the spacing. This is not alpha R yet. So this is not the alpha R yet. Okay, this is how they calculate the ratio between S over R. So then later on they obtain the alpha is equal. For example, this is example for alpha 0.48. Okay, so the average alpha is equal to 2.56. Okay, so sorry, this is the total of the alpha, which is 2.56. Okay. So later on, to get the KZ and CZ value, okay. So four is the number of the pile, okay, by 378 is from the KZ over the alpha R, and four is number of pile, 947 is the CZ for one single pile, okay. So that's why they multiply with 4 and divide with 2.56. So then, okay, so that is for the KZ and CZ. Then continue calculate for the whole system. Based on DF 1.5, G to 28,000, S1 and S2 is 2.5 and 6.8, is 2.7 and 6.7. The R0 is equal to 0.1 times 2.1 over pi square root. Sorry, the table 5.2. Okay, maybe I missed the table 5.2 here. So I will provide the table 5.2 later on. Okay. So then for the KZ, GS, DF, and S1, okay, is equal to 113.4. Okay. And then for the last one is the CZ. So it equal to 277.33. Okay. So for the all the stiffness is equal to 704.03, and for the damping ratio equal to 424.69. Okay, so that is for the KZ and CZ has been asked from the question. So I will attach the table 5.2, okay, to get the S1. Oh, here, I guess here. Okay, so this is table 5.2. S 2.7 and 6.7. Okay. Based on the Poisson ratio value. So, the Poisson ratio here is 0.5. So when we refer to the table, if 0.5, we may use the S1 2.7 and S2 6.7. So this is the result for the KZ and also for the CZ. This is for the floating types, okay? For the group of file. Okay, the last one is the example for to determine the damping ratio. Width of the pile cap, total width of the pile and machines. So then later on can be calculated for the what we call as for the damping ratio, okay, 0.49. So the machine is 70. The pile cap can we can refer to the it's okay. So this is the pile cap. One point eight is the height of the pile cap, which is 0.3 plus 1.5, so 1.8. So the size is 2.1 and 2.1. So the total weight, okay then. So then this is the damping ratio. Okay. So sorry for the example for the floating. Okay. We just want to get what we call as the properties of system of the pile. For example, for damping stiffness. Okay. Why for the friction, if why for the end bearing, we want to identify what will be the natural frequency. So I didn't know why the author not share the same discussion. Supposed to be on the what we call it on the floating, should also discuss on the natural frequency. Okay. So then with that, I end on our last chapter. So